Welcome to the CorpVault channel. In this series, we started discussing deduplication engines. In our previous video, we covered how to seal deduplication database when it goes corrupt. In this video, we will continue discussing the other options. Please like, share, comment or suggest. Subscribe for more videos. And you can follow us on Instagram. The next option to discuss is run space reclamation. During data aging process, the CommServ identifies all the jobs that meet the retention rules. Then, physical pruning occurs on the jobs that meet the retention rules. When you disable physical pruning on the DDB, ongoing pruning and future pruning operations on the DDB partitions are prevented. To validate and prune aged data in a DDB, you must perform a space reclamation operation. After the operation completes, the DDB is automatically marked for validation and pruning of aged data. The other important reason to use the space reclamation feature on a deduplication engine is to reclaim idle space on disk mount paths that do not support sparse files by deleting the invalid data blocks and the orphan chunks. What is a sparse file? As per Wikipedia, a sparse file is a type of computer file that attempts to use file system space more efficiently when the file itself is partially empty. Say you have a file with many empty bytes. These many empty bytes are called holes. Storing empty bytes is just not efficient, and we know there are many of them in the file, so why store them on the storage device? We could instead store metadata describing those as zeros. When a process reads the file, those zero-byte blocks get generated dynamically, as opposed to being stored on physical storage. This is why a sparse file is efficient, because it does not store the zeros on disk. Instead, it holds enough data describing the zeros that will be generated. What are the advantages of using sparse files? We will discuss a few. Empty blocks of data do not occupy disk space. They are not stored as the regular blocks of data. Their identifiers are stored instead in the file metadata. Reading an empty block of data from a sparse file does not take time. This happens because no data is read from disk. Since the file system knows all the bytes in the block are zero, it just sets to zero all the bytes in the input buffer, and the data is ready. There is no need to access the slow storage device. Writing an empty block of data into a sparse file does not take time. On writing, the file system detects that the block is empty and puts the block ID into the list of empty blocks. No data is written to the disk. Run space reclamation window. Before you start a space reclamation operation, make sure no DDB move, DDB reconstruction, or DDB verification jobs running against the storage policy, because during the space reclamation process, the DDB is consulted until the reclamation process is complete. If any one of the operation is running, the space reclamation operation does not start, and an error message is generated. Wait for the operation to complete, and then run the space reclamation operation. Since feature release 21, there have been changes made in the list of data verification options. The options verification of deduplication database and reclaim idle space on mount paths are removed. The option quick verification of deduplication database is changed to quick verification of existing jobs on disk and deduplication database. You can perform space reclamation for a DDB similar to data verification. the option, Validate and Prune Aged Data, that you can perform for a DDB is removed. The validation and pruning of aged data for a DDB is performed along with space reclamation. Select Source Media Agent allows you to select the source media agent from which you will run the space reclamation job. The media agent should be one of the media agents displayed in the Data Paths tab of the Storage Policy copy. When any media agent is selected, the system automatically picks up the appropriate media agent, especially when multiple media agents are associated with the copy. This ensures faster reads from the copy. Defragmentation options. Reclamation level. Select the level of reclamation to be done. As the note says, higher reclamation level will free up more space, but will incur higher IO on mount paths. On the slider, the numbers indicate the percentage of unused data blocks that can be defragmented. 1 is equal to 80%, least aggressive reclamation, low IO on the disk. 2 is equal to 60%. 3 is equal to 40%. And 4 is equal to 20%, most aggressive reclamation, higher IO on the disk. Select the option, Clean Orphan Data, to prune the orphan chunks and the orphan blocks. Number of streams to be used in parallel. By default, allow maximum is selected to use the maximum number of streams during the space reclamation operation. Number of streams allows you to select the number of streams to be used during the space reclamation operation. If the number of streams specified are less than 50, for example 15, then 15 streams are used during the verify data phase, and 15 streams are used during the validate data phase. If the number of streams specified is more than 50, then 50 streams are used during the verify data phase, and 50 streams are used during the validate data phase. If no streams are specified, and the allow maximum is selected, then 20 streams are used during the verify data phase, and 50 streams are used during the validate data phase. Use the description field to enter a description, like the reason for running the job, or ticket number, or cautionary notes, etc. Click Advanced. Advanced Options window. Alert tab. You can set alert for the space reclamation job from here, that is for job activity, or job completed with errors, or job failed, etc. Use Scalable Resource Allocation. This option is grayed out for us, but if you see the option enabled, and if selected, the scalability of the space reclamation operation is enhanced, and the CommServe resources are optimally utilized. Job Initiation tab. You can either run the space reclamation job immediately, or schedule it to run at a later date or time. By default, the DDB space reclamation operation is automatically associated with the system-created schedule policy. This schedule policy runs a full space reclamation job every day at 11 a.m. on one active DDB a day. The interval between two consecutive space reclamation jobs on a DDB is set to 30 days. By default, all the deduplication databases are assigned to this system-created schedule policy for DDB space reclamation, but the space reclamation process runs only on the mount paths that do not support hole drilling. This schedule policy also selects and runs a space reclamation job on those DDB engines on which a full DDB reconstruction job was run. Once done, click OK to start the space reclamation job. You should see the job displayed in the Job Controller window. The DDB is marked for validation and pruning of aged data during the space reclamation operation. What happens in a space reclamation job? We have observed three phases of the job. Validate dedupe data phase, orphan chunk listing phase, and defragment data phase. In the validate dedupe data phase, a quick data verification runs on the DDB. The orphan chunk listing phase marks those blocks and chunks as orphan that are not referenced by any data block. This phase uses a single stream, and if the data verification job is suspended during this phase, then on restarting the job, the listing phase also restarts. The defragment data phase processes the files that can be defragmented, those identified in the first phase, and the orphan chunks, those identified in the second phase, by deleting the invalid or orphan data blocks, thereby reclaiming the unused space. The job details window displays the estimated completion time and percentage complete per phase. If you are using removable disk drives and plug-and-play disk libraries and wish to enable space reclamation on them, then use this command. The prerequisite is the CommServe and the media agent should be on V11 with service pack 11 or higher. Open the command prompt as admin and log onto the CommServe using qlogin. After successful login, run the Q script using the exact parameters. Finally, run the data aging job. To disable space reclamation from removable disk drives and plug-and-play disk libraries, run this command. Lastly, you can view the DDB space reclamation job history at the CommCell level and at the deduplication database level. We will end this video here and discuss the other options in our next video. Please hit the like button if you like this video and subscribe to our channel if not already done so. Thank you. Do subscribe for more videos.